And now the waiting is finally over for Jonathan. It's time to see how his brand of magic plays in a grand final.
We're now going to take you to the world of illusion. Would you please give a nice warm welcome back? Here he is, Mr. Jonathan Miller.
Backstage, Chloe's emotions have rather got the better of her.
How did it feel? Kicking?
I'm crying. I'm the dog's bollocks, I'm sorry.
Is your manager out there? Is your manager out there?
No, he's on holiday.
Good evening. Thank you very much indeed. Oh, ladies and gentlemen, it's lovely to be back. This next trick I once performed to the Queen of the Belgians. Well, he said he was the Queen of the Belgians. He said, if you're a magician, then I'm the Queen of the Belgians. You see, it's a little round rod with four pom-poms. There's a white pom-pom, a red pom-pom, a yellow pom-pom, and there's a pretty little blue one. And there's two strings. There's a long string on this side and a short one on this side. Which is strange, there's always a long string on this side, a short one on this side, and a long one on this side, and a short one on the top. They're like that. Do you know, it's funny because you see, you can actually see inside. Just strange. Ladies and gentlemen, thank you for having me. And for those of you that haven't, I'll be in the car park in 10 minutes.
It's now up to Jonathan to close the whole show with his own glitter-packed finale.
I'm gonna make a brand new start of it. It's up to you, New York, New York, New York.
Oh, well, there we are, ladies and gentlemen. That was act number 12, Jonathan Miller, if that's going to be the act of your choice this evening.
For the last time, the judges are to give their verdict, a moment Jonathan dreads much more than facing any audience. And he's first in line.
I'll be honest with you. Before we go any further, I mean, forget Bobby Crush, forget Danny LaRue, 45 years in the business. That guy is show business. That guy is brilliant, and we need more of it.
Lovely. Thank you very much indeed. Thank you. Thank you. Kevin, you book a lot of female vocalists
onto
this circuit. Chloe, what did you make of this lovely young lady?
Well, when she came on and I heard the intro to the song, I thought, oh, Christ. What's this going to sound like? And I thought, bloody hell. That really is the dog's
dangly bits.
Yes, yes, yes.
Too much of a woman for you, dear.
Yeah. I can't answer that, but I'll I'll have a chat with you at playtime. Yeah.
Thank you to the panel. We'll see you backstage. We'll deliberate now and we'll be back with part three of Stairway to Stars. We'll see you then. Thank you.
While the judges leave to tot up their scores, the acts gather to fret together. Jolene was in the dressing room when Chloe was on, and she's still on a high.
I don't know what I feel. I feel ashamed. I don't care. I've got through to the final. Quite happy with my performance.
But her mother was watching Chloe, the girl they'd always beaten before.
I say, Chloe's come on. Did you watch her?
I haven't given him a paging.
Hang on, have you got it there?
Hello.
Oh, Judy. Judy's got
Nobody
it
in the dressing
room. In the VIP dressing room, the judges' marks are counted. Each score a verdict on which of the finalists has what it takes to make it.
Bruce Parker, 21. Yeah. Joan, 30. Yeah.
It's a moment that might change any one of their careers, and it all rests on the judgment of the panel.
But this is Irish dancing, because I used to teach that, Judy, you see.
No.
No, I didn't.
He said that during
and
that
was,
guy,
I was
yeah.
watching it very technically, very stiff.
Is
no
he
passion,
stiff?
No feeling at all. Such an arrogant little bugger, too, you know, talking to him as I came through, and I said, look, you know, and he was venomous about certain judges who were nameless.
May we see how it should be done?
Not in my state of pregnancy, don't
no.
I've just had an affair with a camp performer, number 12.
Jolene's mother, meanwhile, has revised her lineup of winners.
Bruce.
Oh, was it? Oh, he's got a wicked...
Chloe, probably, I think, now, after seeing her. Still not my kind of voice, but I do think she's come on.
Andre.
And a Chinese girl, probably.
Now, at last, after a long, hot summer of tears and torment, Britain's most promising amateur talent act is about to be announced.
Now comes the moment of truth. We've got to our third, our second, and our first, traditionally in reverse order. So, these are the results of the grand final of Stairway to the Stars, 1999. In third position, to receive a silver salver and a cheque for £150, it is Act Number 6, Bruce Parker. It's a pleasure to introduce you now to the runner-up to the Stairway to the Stars Grand Final, 1999, to receive a cheque for £350 and a silver salver, Jonathan Miller, Act Number 12. And now, ladies and gentlemen, the winner of the Herald Express 1999 Stairway to the Stars to receive a silver salver and a cheque for £1,000. The winner is Act Number 11, Chloe Russell.
As the night draws to an end, Jolene heads home with plans for next time.
Stairway to the Stars. In it next year. New songs, new dress.
Oh, I love my
new hair.
Yeah, I'll be down here. I'm going to have it long now.
But the comments, honestly, the judges' comments were great.
And her old rival, Chloe, who'd never won a competition this big before, gets her first taste of fame.
Did you feel that on stage?
I felt as if, you know, everybody was just watching me, and it was just lush, and I was just like, I don't know how to explain it. It's just a feeling that you can only ever feel when you actually do win. It's really hard to explain.
Well, for Jonathan, it's just about what he always dreamed of.
Because your style, you know, the guy who was on earlier was producing pigeons every time you spoke. You came on, nothing happened except glitter. And we all went, ooh, glitter, isn't it wonderful? Let's have him. Lovely, marvellous.
Thank you very much.
Oh, stiff hair.
Oh, how lovely. I'm so thrilled.
I heard that.
Since the final, Chloe has been working as a sales assistant and has entered another talent competition in Exeter. Bruce has gone on a concert tour of seaside holiday camps. And Jonathan is back at work in the family hardware shop.